I could cry.
Seriously,
I'm so
happy.
Emotional.
Tears,
huh? Absolute tears of joy, tears of happiness.
The flowers are for Sneha, Sneha Saitya. She's a home chef and she has invited us to her home at CR Park this afternoon to taste a typical Assamese lunch.
Whenever we have tried regional cuisine in Delhi, we've been mostly disappointed. I remember going to a very famous Bengali restaurant and then the food was so bad that I had written off Bengali food forever. Devrata's mother invited me for a dinner at her home. So I realized that regional Indian cuisine is best tasted at home. Devrata's mother is not around all the time. So when we have to try regional cuisine, like good quality, hygienic, tasty regional cuisine, another option is going to a home chef. So Sneha Saikia, she's a food blogger friend and she's been globetrotting, but you know, her love for regional cuisine, especially Bengali and Assamese, like her native place, is unparalleled. When she invited us to try her cooking, especially for Assamese cuisine, we left everything and you know, said yes.
So you are the chef, so you should look like a chef.
So I
So lucky for us that Sneha is in town and she does this table for six occasionally, and the table is all set. We started with a welcome drink and you know, we know there's luck coming for us. Say hi. So these are, like, you know, other friends who are going to eat with us. That's Sneha in her apron.
Boyfriend.
This is Kasha.
Kasha. Okay, bell metal. Yeah.
From yesteryears.
Anguli pitha. Mm-hmm. Anguli means fingers. Mm-hmm. So we shape it like a finger. This is also one kind of pitha.
This is all made with rice flour. Huh?
Yes, this is rice flour. Mm-hmm. Black sesame. This one is my idea.
I've had this pitha in Bengal. This variety.
ये भांग के बीज से बनता है ना, पत्ते से नहीं। पत्ते में थोड़ा नशा होता है मेरे ख्याल
में, होता है बीज में,
बीज में नहीं होता। ये उत्तराखंड में भी बड़ा यूज करते हैं भांग के बीज से चटनी बनाना, वो भी मतलब उत्तराखंड क्विजीन में इट्स अ मस्ट। देयर इज नो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रोटी, लूची और पराठा।
लूची इज देयर नाउ इन मॉडर्न असमीज क्विजीन।
ओके,
दैट्स ओनली फॉर एज अ स्नैक।
ओके, बट मेन कोर्स इज मोस्टली ईटन विद राइस।
ओके, and the dish which we make with khar is alkaline. Mm-hmm. It's also known as khar. So आज मैंने पपीते का बनाया.
ग्रेट.
कभी आप फिश हेड डाल के बना सकते हैं
या खार इज यूज्ड
के पत्ते का बना सकते हैं. खार इज
यूज्ड इट इज प्रिपेयर्ड इज यूज्ड
इन नाइन हां सोडा
यूज्ड इन मेनी डिशेस.
यस
नाइस.
इज इट सिमिलर टू भरता.
नो
खार मींस खट्टा.
सोडा होता है ना मीठा सोडा. वो घर में बनाया हुआ मीठा सोडा है. केले के पील जो होता है केले का उसको जला ड्राई करके बिल्कुल ऐश करके फिर उसमें ड्रॉप ड्रॉप पानी डालते हैं और जो रेसिपी मिलता है दैट इज अल्कलाइन.
और एसमीज कुजीन भी ऐसा कुछ है बाय डिफॉल्ट हाथ से खाते हैं या स्पून से खाते हैं?
हाथ से ही खाते हैं.
हाथ से ही खाते हैं.
सो आई जस्ट इफ यू डोंट माइंड
इफ यू
प्लीज प्लीज
लाइक बंगाली कुजीन दिस इज ऑल्सो बेस्ट टेस्टेड विद योर हैंड. And we foodies, we don't like anything between our food and us. So no spoons.
You like this
one? Thanks a lot.
Drumsticks. Okay. Sujne pata.
With baby potatoes. So in Assamese we call this bhekuri pita.
Achha.
Bhekuri pita pitika.
Achha.
So bhekuri pita is very very bitter.
Okay.
So I have mixed it with aloo.
Achha.
And we call it pitika. Pitika means mashed.
Okay.
Chutney mein aata hai. Hum logon ka chutney jyada hota hai.
Achha.
Boiled and mashed curry se jyada hota hai.
Okay. अच्छा.
टेंगा मीन्स खट्टा. वी स्टार्ट आवर मील विद अल्कलाइन
ओके
खार एंड एंड आवर मील विद टेंगा जस्ट टू क्लीन अवर पैलेट.
ओके
दिस इज आवर ट्रेडिशनल वे ऑफ ईटिंग.
अच्छा.
सो इन बिटवीन यू कैन हैव मीट चटनी वेजिटेबल वट एवर यू वॉन्ट.
ओके एंड वट ऑल गोज इन दिस?
ओनली मस्टर्ड ऑयल मेथी सीड्स एंड टोमेटो.
ओके
एंड ग्रीन चिलीज और थोड़ा सा नींबू.
ओके
आई कुड क्राई. Seriously, I'm so
happy tears, huh?
Absolute tears of joy, tears of happiness, tears of mangshu.
Okay.
Mm. And that's, tears of patlamach.
That's Bengali speaking.
Yeah.
So the Assamese cuisine is quite similar to Bengali cuisine. I mean, I can see a lot of similarities like mustard oil and rice and pithe. But still, it is very unique. I mean, you know, it feels like I have had this kind of food before, but it still feels like I'm having something absolutely unique. And another thing that I noticed is that I won't call it predominantly vegetarian or non-vegetarian because there's a lot for vegetarians. I mean, Sneha has used veggies, herbs, and pulses and whatnot. And then there is for non-vegetarians, for carnivores, there's mangsho dish too. And that too cooked in a unique Assamese style. So it is like a win-win for everybody.
If you talk, I mean, if you divide Assam in food-wise, not geographical-wise, it's three parts. You can divide it into three parts. One is tribal belt, one is mainland where all these tea gardens are there and all these traders have entered, no? Main Central Assam. So Central Assam is influenced with all Marwaris and Uriya people and Bengali who have come for trading and all and making a tea garden. So this is that Central Assam food.
Okay.
To for this palate, no? For everybody. And another one is tribal belt, which is near banks of Brahmaputra, which is always flooding. So that food is always with fermented fish, fermented vegetables, everything is either dry or fermented. And then another part towards the Dibrugarh side is Ahoms are there, Ahom tribe. So Ahoms use everything water-based, not a single drop of oil. So it's similar to Thai.
Okay, then must be really healthy.
Very healthy. Yeah. Even in these food, I have used only one spoon of oil.
Okay.
In the fish, there is only one teaspoon. Just for the methi.
Okay.
And mangsho also, I think it's only 3 tablespoons for 1 kg mangsho.
Okay.
It's cooked with the goat pita fat.
Okay.